budding? Are you all happy? Are you all happy to hear a story? Yes, this video is for the children, belongs to class 4, subject moral science, lesson 12, session 12. The topic is friends meet again. Do you have your friend, best friend? Yes, some of you may have best friend. How do you feel when you meet each other? You may feel so happy, isn't it? Okay, let us get into the video. Who is meeting his friend? Okay, before we get into our video, we'll have a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we praise you and glorify your name. We thank you for all the blessings you have bestowed upon us. Thank you for providing our needs and for giving us chance to continue our study. Bless our teachers who inspire and guide us. Bless our parents who work and support us. Bless our classmates and friends who care for us. We are humbly asking for your guidance as we begin our online class today. Send us your Holy Spirit so we may understand and achieve the objective of our lesson. Help us to listen attentively to our teachers so we may accept the knowledge imparted to us. Give us the energy and strength to participate in today's online class. Help us to be more focused so we may complete the activities and tasks for today. Fill us with joy, fill our minds with learning and our class with peace. We ask of these through Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. What is the topic? Friends meet again. It was early Sunday morning, still dark. Suddenly, bright rays of light shone on the tomb where Jesus lay. The angel Gabriel came from heaven down this path of light. His face was as bright as lightning, so bright. The earth shook. The soldiers who were guarding the tomb fell trembling to the ground. They saw the angel roll away a heavy stone. And you can see the picture over here. They trembling and they fell down. And the angel Gabriel here, and you can see the stone, okay, in the angel, okay, the angel rolled away the stone and Jesus risen. And here the soldier heard the angel cry out, "Son of God, arise, come out, your father calls you." Jesus stepped out of the tomb. Suddenly, the bright light was gone. Jesus was gone too. The soldiers stared at the open tomb. They were looking inside. They quickly got up and started running to Pilate's palace, okay, King's palace. They must tell him what had happened. And the same morning before sunrise, Mary Magdalene walked to the garden tomb. She was carrying perfumes and spices to put on Jesus' body. As she came to the tomb, she couldn't believe what she saw. The big stone had been taken away from the opening of the tomb. She looked in. It's empty. Someone has taken his body. Mary cried, because in those days they used to steal the dead bodies. Okay, so she thought like that. Someone has taken his body. And she cried. She turned and ran to tell the disciples. While she was gone, other women came into the garden. They saw a young man sitting beside the opening of the tomb. He said to them, "Jesus is not here. He has risen." The woman went into the tomb. They saw an angel inside. He said to them, "Remember Jesus told you before he died that he would rise again on the third day. Okay, so then their sorrow turned to joy. They were very happy. Quickly, they hurried off to tell the disciples. The disciples had locked themselves in the upstairs room where they had eaten supper with Jesus. Mary got to the room first. The tomb is empty, she said, all out of breath. Okay, she was running and coming, no? So she said very happily. Peter and John ran as fast as they could to the tomb. Yes, the tomb is empty. What Mary told us is true, Peter cried. They hurried back to the to tell the other disciples. Okay, see how happy they were, isn't it? Okay, here the tomb is empty. Here you can see the picture of a stone rolled away from the tomb. Okay, and here you can see the picture of Peter and John running. After Peter and John left, Mary walked into the tomb and saw two angels. Okay, angels there. And why are you crying? They ask kindly. Because they have taken away Jesus' body, she said. Then she stepped out of the tomb. There stood Jesus. But Mary thought he was a gardener. She did not see who he was because she was crying. She didn't notice who was standing there. Why are you crying? Jesus asked. Sir, she said, if you took him away, please tell me where he is. Jesus said in a familiar voice, Mary. Then she knew who he was. Jesus, she said. Jesus answered, I cannot stop to talk to you now. First I must see my heavenly Father. Then Jesus disappeared. Here you can see the picture of Jesus here. Mary sitting and crying. And they were very happy. See their face. Okay, well, they heard that Jesus is rising. See, everybody's talking about Jesus. Mary's tear turned to joy. Jesus was alive. She had seen him. Jesus also greeted the other women who were still on their way to the disciples. When the women reached the disciples in the upstairs room, they all began to talking at once. Jesus lives. He talked to us. Impossible. Simply impossible, the other disciples said. Okay? They could not believe that the woman's story was really true. So this glad morning was a sad one for the disciples who didn't believe. Okay? So you must believe that Jesus is rising and he is, where is now? He is in heaven, isn't it? Okay? And the memory verse says, I am he who liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive for evermore. Okay, repeat after me. I am he who liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive for evermore. Marithen, analum sadakalangalum uyirode irikkiren. Okay, Jesus says, I am he who liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive for evermore. Revelation chapter 1. Verse 18 says, okay, from the King James Version. KJV means King James Version. There are so many versions of Bible. So this memory verse is taken from King James Version, okay, KJV. I am he who liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive for evermore. Okay, children, memorize this memory verse and try to write the book exercise and find answer for the questions given in your book. Okay, children, thank you all. God bless you. Thank you for watching this video.